So when you calculate AE, A is 3, E is 2 by 3. So when you cancel this 3, you will get A is equal to 2. So what are the boundaries here? X is equal to minus 2 and X is equal to plus 2. So in order to calculate the area, you have to calculate what is Y is. So Y square by 5 is equal to 1 minus X square by 9. Therefore, Y square is equal to 5 by 9 into 9 minus X square. Therefore, Y is equal to root 5 by 3 into root of 9 minus X square. So what is the required area here is 4 times 0 to 2 y into dx. So 4 into root 5 by 3, 0 to 2 root of 9 minus x square into dx. What is the integration of root of 9 minus x square using the formula of root of a square minus x square? That is x by 2 into root of 9 minus x square plus 9 by 2 into sine inverse of x by 3. Applying the limit 0 to 2. Therefore, on cancelling these two here, we will get 2 by root 5 by 3, x into root of, when we substitute x is equal to 2 here, we will get 2 into root of 9 minus 4. What is 9 minus 4? That is 5. So we will get root 5. So 2 root 5 plus 9 into sine inverse of, expand these 2, therefore 2 by 3. What about the lower limit? Lower limit becomes 0. So this is the required area of the ellipse cut off by two latest rectums. Area between two curves. Now let us consider two functions y1 is equal to f of x and y2 is equal to g of x. Now these two curves will intersect at the point say x is equal to a and x is equal to b above the x axis. Now y1 is greater than y2. Therefore area between the two curves is defined as integral x is equal to a, x is equal to a to x is equal to b, y1 minus y2 into dx. Or otherwise you can say that y1 must be what? Greater than y2. Suppose y2 is greater than y1 means you have to use the formula y2 minus y1. Or you can put it in this way, integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b, f of x minus e of x dx, provided f of x must be greater than g of x. Here y1 is f of x, y2 is what? G of x. So in order to use the angle between the two curves, so you have to use the formula y1 minus y2 dx. Example 1. Find the area bounded by the curve y is equal to x cube and y is equal to x. Here there are two curves given, y is equal to x cube and y is equal to x. So first of all you have to draw the curve. So for that purpose, we have to solve these two equations to get the point of intersection. Here, y is equal to x cube and y is equal to x. Since the left hand sides are equal, therefore the right hand side values are also equal. Therefore, x cube is equal to x. Therefore, x cube minus x is equal to 0. So, if we factorize this, we will get x into x square minus 1. So, this is x is equal to 0, x plus 1 into x minus 1. What is x square minus 1 is? X plus 1 into x minus 1. Therefore, x is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to 1. So, the curve intersects at 0, minus 1 and 1. When x is equal to 0, what is y value? Y is also 0 because y is equal to x. So, x and y values must be the same. Therefore, x is equal to 1 means y is also equal to 1. X is equal to minus 1 means y is also equal to minus 1. So, we know that y is equal to x cube is a curve will be like this. And y is equal to x is a line will be like this. So they will intersect at 1, 1 as well as in minus 1, 1 and also it passes through the origin. Y is equal to x is a line passing through origin and y is equal to x cube is also a line passing through origin. Now this is the intersect portion. So first of all you are going to calculate the area under this portion. Multiply with the 2 will get the total area. So therefore the area between the two curve is twice integral 0 to 1. That means we are using the boundary from 0 to 1, y1 minus y2 into dx. So here y1 is what? Y is equal to x. Y2 is what? Y is equal to x cube. Here y1 is what? Greater than y2. Let us see this. Y1 in the diagram, you can see that y1 is greater than y2. So what is y1 is x, y2 is x cube, 0 to 1. Therefore, what is integral of x is x square by 2, x cube integration x to the power of 4 by 4. So applying the upper limit minus lower limit, 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. What is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4? It is 1 by 4. So 2 into 1 by 4 becomes 1 by 2 square units. So that is the area between the two curves, that is 1 by 2 square units. Example 2. Find the common area enclosed by the parabola 4y square is equal to 9x and 3x square is equal to 16y. Now 4y square is equal to 9x and 3x square is equal to 16y, both are parabolas. So we want to find where these two curves will intersect. So for that purpose I am squaring the first equation. Why I am squaring? Because we are adding 3x square. So when you square this, we will get 16 into y to the power of 4 is equal to 81x square. Now 81x square can be written as 27 to 3x square. We know that from the second equation, 3x square is equal to 16y. So substitute the 16y here instead of 3x square. So therefore 16 will be get cancelled. So y to the power of 4 is equal to 27y. So when you cancel this y, we get y cube is equal to 27. 27 can be written as 3 cube. Therefore y is equal to 3. So when y is equal to 3, let us see what is the value of x. X is equal to 4y square by 9. From the first equation, we see that 4y square is equal to 9x. Therefore, x is equal to 4y square by 9. So what is y value? 3. 3 square is what? 9. So 9 will be get cancelled. We get 4. So what is the point of intersection is? 4, 3. Now you can see that 4y square is equal to 9x is a parabola in the open rightward. And 3x square is equal to 16y is a parabola open upward. So they will intersect at 4, 3. Both the curves will pass us through the origin. So this is the shaded portion is nothing but the area between the two curves. So how to find the area between the two curves? So you have to use the integration x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 4 y1 minus y2 into dx. Here 4y square is equal to 9x is y1. Therefore y square is equal to 9x by 4. Therefore y is equal to 3 by 2 into root x. So this is the first curve which is greater than the second curve. 16y is equal to 3x square. Therefore y is equal to 3 into x square. 3x square by 16. Now applying this y1 and y2 in this equation. Therefore 0 to 4, 3 by 2, y1 is nothing but what? Root x. 3 by 2 into root x. y2 is what? 3x square by 16 into x square. So 3 by 2 into root x integration is 2 by 3 x root x. Please note the result. Root x integration is 2 by 3 x root x. 3 by 16, x square integration is x cube by 3. Here 3 will be get cancelled, 2 will be get cancelled. Here is also 3 will be get cancelled. So applying the upper limit, we will get 4 into root 4 is 2. 1 by 16 into 4 cube is 64. 16 into 4, 64. 4 into 2, 8. So what is 8 minus 4? 4 square units. So what is the area between the two curves is 4 square units. Example 3. Find the area of the region common to the circles x square plus y square is equal to 60 and the parabola y square is equal to 6x. So x square plus y square is equal to 16 is a circle for which the radius of the circle is what? 4 units. Therefore whose center is 0, 0 and radius is 4 units. So this is a circle. And y square is equal to 6x is a parabola open rightward. Now these two curves will intersect at two different points. Now we want to find the area of the full portion. So first of all I am going to calculate the area of this portion, shaded portion, which can be converted into two parts, that is part 1 and part 2. So part 1 from 0 to this part and the second part will be from this area to this area. So in order to get the point of intersection, we have to solve the two equations. Since x square plus y square is equal to 16, we know that y square is equal to 6x which is given. So substituting the value here, x square plus 6x is equal to 16, x square plus 6x minus 16 is equal to 0. On factorizing this quadratic equation, we will get x plus 8 into x minus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore x is equal to minus 8 and x is equal to 2. So x is equal to 8 is not a possible value because it is in the first quadrant. Therefore you have to take x is equal to 2. So when x is equal to 2, y square is equal to 6 into 2, that is 12. Therefore, y is equal to root of 12. Root of 12 can be written as 4 into 3. Therefore, 2 root 3. So what about the point of intersection is 2 comma 2 root 3. Now what is the required area? The required area is a is equal to 2 times area of the first part plus area of the second part. Why I am putting 2? Because the upper part as well as the lower part. So area 1 plus area 2, then doubles will get the total area bounded by the 2 curves. Therefore, the required area is capital A is equal to 2 into I1 plus I2. What is I1 denotes the first area, I2 denotes the second area. Therefore, area is equal to twice integral 0 to 2. What is the first curve is? The upper curve is what? Y square is equal to 6x. Therefore, y is equal to root 6 into root x plus the second term is 0 to 2, it is bounded by the circle. Therefore, y is equal to root of 16 minus x square into dx. So, twice root 6 root x integration is what? 2 by 3 x root x. What is 16 minus x square dx is? X by 2 into root of 16 minus x square plus 16 by 2 into sine inverse of x by 4. Therefore, 2 into root 16, 2 by 3, and you substitute the upper limit, 2 root 2 plus x is equal to means 2 by 2, which will be cancelled. 16 minus 2 square becomes 4 plus 8 into, so 16 2 times will get cancelled, that is 8 sine inverse of x is 2 by 4. What is 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. So, what is sine inverse of 1 by 2 is what? Pi by 6. So, 16 minus 4 is root 12. So, 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 6, root 6 into root 2 becomes root 12. So, twice 4 by 3 into root 12 plus root 12 plus 8 by 5 by 6. Again, this will be get cancelled. 4 2s are, 4 3s are. So, multiplying with 2 will get 2 into 4 into 2, which gives you what? 16 root 3 will be get cancelled here. So, 16 by root 3. 2 into 2 becomes 4 root 3 plus 4 into 2, 8 by 3 pi. So many square units. Example 4. Compute the area between the curve y is equal to sin x and y is equal to cos x on the line x is equal to 0 and x is equal to pi. Now we know that y is equal to sin x is a curve. It will pass through the origin and it cuts the x axis at pi. So this is a sine curve. And y is equal to cos x will be starting from the y axis, that is 1, because cos 0 is 1. So it moves to x axis and it cuts the x axis at pi by 2 and it will be goes on like this. So this is the two curves, y is equal to cos x and y is equal to sin x. So they will intersect at one particular point here. So we have to find the common point. So we know that sin x is equal to cos x. This implies that x is equal to 45 degree. So only when x is equal to 45 degree, sin x is equal to cos x, because it is in the first quadrant. Therefore, x is equal to pi by 4. Therefore, the required area is equal to integral 0 to pi by 4 cos x minus sin x. Here, cos x is greater than sin x. Then we are going to find the area between pi by 4 to pi. Here, sin x is greater than cos x. See the diagram here. Therefore, sin x minus cos x will be dx. So, what is cos x integration is sin x? Sin x integration is minus cos x. So minus into minus becomes plus cos x. Plus sin x integration is minus cos x. Cos x integration is sin x. Already arrived minus sin, therefore minus sin x. So sin 45 is 1 by root 2, cos 45 is 1 by root 2. So applying the lower limit, sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1. So we get minus 1. Plus cos pi is minus 1. So minus of minus 1 becomes plus 1. Sin pi is 0. Lower limit is minus of cos 45 is 1 by root 2, so minus 1 by root 2. Sin 45 is also 1 by root 2, so minus 1 by root 2. Here plus 1 and minus 1 will be get cancelled. So when you add these two values, we get minus 2 by root 2. So 2 by root 2 minus of minus 2 by root 2. So what is minus into minus? Plus 2 by root 2. So we can cancel this root 2 with 2, that is root 2. Similarly here, root 2. Root 2 plus root 2 gives you what? 2 root 2 square units. So that is the area between the two curves. Example 5. Find the area of the region enclosed by y square is equal to x and y is equal to x minus 2. So in order to find the area between these two curves, we have to solve these two equations. So the first equation is y square is equal to x and y is equal to x minus 2. So substituting y is equal to x minus 2 in the first equation, we will get x minus 2 the whole square is equal to x. So by expanding x minus 2 the whole square, we get x square minus 4x plus 4 equal to x. On simplifying this, we will get x square minus 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. So we are getting a quadratic equation. So by factorizing this equation, we get x minus 4 into x minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 4 and x is equal to 1. When x is equal to 4, the value of y is 2. When x is equal to 1, the value of y is equal to minus 1. So substituting x is equal to 4 and 1, in the given equation, y is equal to x minus 2. So we will get two different points, that is 4, 2 and 1, minus 2. So here is a diagram. This is a point 4, 2 and minus 1, 1. So this is a straight line and this is a parabola y square is equal to x. The area bounded by is the shaded portion here, you have drawn here. So here the boundaries are y is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to 2, because the two curves is based on y axis. Therefore, the required area is equal to integral y is equal to minus 1 to y is equal to 2 x1 minus x2 into dy, because it is based on y axis. So y axis means x dy. So x1 means first curve, x2 means second curve. What's the first curve is the straight line, x2 means the parabola. So therefore, from the equation y is equal to x minus 2, we can calculate y is equal to x minus 2, therefore x is equal to y plus 2. From the equation 2, x is equal to y square. So substituting here, y plus 2 minus y square into dy. So what is the integral of y is y square by 2, integral of 2 is 2y, y square is y cube by 3. So substituting upper limit, we will get 4 by 2 plus 4 minus 8 by 3. Substituting the lower limit, we will get 1 by 2 minus 2 plus 1 by 3. On simplifying this, we will get L6 is the LCM. So 3 times 3 4s are 12, 6 4s are 24, 2 6 are 18. Here 6 is the LCM, 3 minus 12 plus 2. So by simplifying this, we will get minus 7. So minus and minus becomes plus 7 by 6. So 20 by 6 plus 7 by 6 gives you what? 27 by 6. By simplifying this, we will get 9 by 2 square units. So that is the required area. Example 6. Find the area bounded by x axis and arc of the cycloid x is equal to a 2t minus sin 2t, y is equal to a into 1 minus cos 2t. Since the curve is bounded by x axis, therefore you are substituting y is equal to 0, because the equation of x axis what? Y is equal to 0. Substituting y is equal to 0 in this equation, we will get 0 is equal to a into 1 minus cos t, divided by a, 1 minus cos 2t is equal to 0. Therefore, cos 2t is equal to 1. Therefore, cos 2n pi is 1, because even number is what? 1. Therefore, 2t is equal to 2n pi. Therefore, t is equal to n pi. So, when n is equal to 0, t is equal to 0. So, substituting n is equal to 0 into pi becomes 0. When n is equal to 1, t is equal to pi. So, the arc lies between t is equal to 0 and t is equal to pi. That is one arc of the curve. Therefore, the boundaries are t is equal to 0 and t is equal to pi. So, here is a diagram. This is an x-axis, y-axis. This is t is equal to 0 and t is equal to pi. This is a cycloid curve. So, we have to find the area bounded by this curve. Therefore, the required area is equal to integral 0 to pi y dx, because the curve is based on the y-axis. So, what is y? Y is equal to a into 1 minus cos 2t. And x is equal to a into 2t minus sin 2t, is it not? Therefore, when you differentiate this x with respect to t, therefore dx is equal to a into derivative of 2t is 2, sin 2 derivative is 2 cos 2t into dt. So, when you take 2 as common factor, we get 2a into 1 minus cos 2t into dt. So, substitute these three values here, that is dx here, and y is equal to a into 1 minus cos t. So, integral 0 to pi, a into 1 minus cos 2t into 2a into 1 minus cos 2t into dt. So 2a into a becomes 2a square, 1 minus cos 2t into 1 minus cos 2t becomes 1 minus cos 2t the whole square into dt. So what is 1 minus cos 2t? That is equal to 2 sin square t. So this is a trigonometric formula in 11th standard. So substituting this value here, we get 4 sin square sin power 4 t into dt. Already we are having 2 a square, therefore 8 a cube. Since this is a even power, therefore integral 0 to 2 a f of x dx, according to the integral property, we can rewrite this is 2 into integral 0 dA f of 2a minus x. Therefore, I am multiplying this with 2, will get 2 into 8, 16 a cube, integral 0 to pi becomes 0 to pi by 2 into sin power 4 into dt. So, according to the integral reduction formula, 0 to pi by 2 sin power 4 x dx is n minus 1 by n into n minus 3 by n minus 1, so on up to pi by 2. So, applying this rule, we get 16 a cube 3 by 4 into 1 by 2 into pi by 2. So, on simplifying this, we'll get 3 pi a square. So, this is the required area. Now, we'll move on to another unit, volume of a solid by revolution of some curves. So, rotating a circle, we'll get a sphere. Suppose if you take a 1 rupee coin, when you rotate, we'll get a sphere. So, circle is a curve, but whereas by rotating the circle, we are getting a solid. Therefore, you will be given a curve and you are getting a solid by rotating the circle. In a straight line, you are getting a cone. So, straight line is a curve, cone is a solid. So, whenever a curve is rotated about the x-axis and y-axis, we will get a solid. So, rotation may be in two different directions. So, one is about x-axis, the curve may be rotated about y-axis. Suppose if the curve is rotated about x-axis, then the volume is integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b pi y square dx. This is a formula we have to use. Suppose if the curve is rotated about y axis, then the volume is equal to integral y is equal to c to y is equal to d pi x square dy. 1. Find the volume of the solid that results when the region enclosed by the curve y is equal to 1 plus x square, x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 0, revolve about the x axis. Since the curve revolves about the x-axis, therefore you have to use the formula pi y square dx. So what is the boundary is x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 2, that is given in the problem itself. So what is the given curve is y is equal to 1 plus x square. So when you square this, we'll get 1 plus x square the whole square into dx. So by expanding this, we'll get 1 plus x to the power of 4 plus 2 x square into dx. By integrating this, we'll get integral of 1 is x, x to the power of 4 is x to the power of 5 by 5, x square integration x cube by 3, applying the limit 1 to 2. Therefore, pi into 2 plus 32 by 5 plus 16 by 3 minus 1 plus 1 by 5 plus 2 by 3. So, by taking LCM, we will get 30 plus 96 plus 80 minus 15 plus 3 plus 10 by 15. So, therefore, the total value for this is 206, whereas the total value is 28. So, by subtracting these two values, we will get 178 pi by 15. So, this is the required volume of this curve. Example 2. Find the volume of the solid by rotating y is equal to x cube. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, is revolved about y axis. So, here is the curve revolves about which axis? Y axis. So, y is equal to x cube is the curve will be like this. And this curve will pass through origin. So, this is x is equal to 0. And when x is equal to 0, what is the value of y? Y is also equal to 0. Whereas the curve cut off by the boundary, that is y is equal to 1. So this curve is rotated about the y axis, we get a solid like this. Therefore, the required volume of the solid is integral y is equal to 0 to y is equal to 1 pi x square dy. So what is x cube? X cube is equal to y. This is a given curve. So from which you are calculating x. Therefore, taking power 1 by 3 on both sides, we will get x is equal to y power 1 by 3. Since we want the x square, therefore I am squaring this value. Therefore, x square is equal to y power 2 by 3. So, substituting y is equal to y power 2 by 3 here, we will get pi into y is equal to 0 to y is equal to 1, y power 2 by 3 into dy. So, what is integral of y power n? That is y power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Applying this formula here, we will get y power 5 by 3 by 5 by 3. 5 by 3 will be noted into 3 pi by 5, y power 5 by 3. So, substituting y is equal to 1 and y is equal to 0 here. So, the upper limit is 1, lower limit is what? 0. Therefore, we get 3 pi by 5 cubic units. So that is the required volume of the solid, that is 3 pi by 5 cubic units. Example 3. Derive the formula for volume of the right circular cone with radius r units and height h. Now, how you are getting a cone? By rotating a straight line. So what is the equation of straight line is y is equal to mx. So what is m? M is tan theta. Therefore, m is equal to tan theta. From the right angle triangle, we see that radius is